With Gateway 3 mounted, the next step is to pull wire and make terminations within the enclosure. To protect both the installer and the equipment, the electrical system should be de-energized and locked out prior to beginning these steps. Please note, this video covers wiring for Gateway 3, which is slightly different from PowerShare Gateway. Wiring for PowerShare Gateway is covered in a separate video. Gateway comes with this bonding screw pre-installed, creating an electrical bond between the neutral busing and the ground lugs. Neutral and ground must only be bonded in the first means of disconnecting power to the home's electrical system. When Gateway is fed from a service disconnect, this bonding screw inside of Gateway must be removed. Alternatively, when Gateway is fed with service entrance conductors and is being used as the main service disconnect, the factory installed bonding screw must remain in place and a main breaker must be installed. Additionally, all other electrical panels in the system must have ground and neutral isolated. Therefore, Gateway must be prepped in one of two ways. Either the neutral to ground bonding screw must be removed with a specified socket, or a main breaker must be installed. To install a main breaker, use a socket to remove these nuts securing the S1 and S2 lugs to the supply busing. Identify the two sets of threaded posts that are used with main breakers. The inner set of posts are used with Eaton main breakers. The outer set of posts are used with square D main breakers. Place the main breaker over the S1 and S2 posts and secure it with two nuts, torquing them to the specs listed inside of the equipment. Secure the bottom portion of the main breaker with the manufacturer-provided hold-down screw. Please note, square D main breakers require an accessory hold-down bracket, which can be ordered through Tesla. Finally, remove the main breaker blanks on the front cover. Square D main breakers require removal of these three blanks, while Eaton main breakers require removal of these two blanks. With Gateway prepped, begin wiring by routing the incoming line 1 and line 2 conductors to the supply terminals or main breaker. Route the incoming neutral and grounding conductors to their respective lugs. Strip the end of each conductor to the length specified on the equipment and terminate to the listed torque values. This label on the front cover is a valuable field resource as it lists torque specs and allowable wire size of all terminations within the equipment. When required by local code, install the lug covers that were provided with the main breaker. The next step is to connect the outgoing conductors that feed the backup load center. Line 1 and line 2 conductors are terminated on these lugs. Neutral and grounding conductors are terminated on their respective lugs. These 5 lugs are rated to accept 2 wires each, provided that they are the same size and material. Please note, neutrals are not allowed to be double lugged unless they are running in a parallel circuit as permitted by code. The internal panel board is 200 amp rated and supports 8 Eaton, Siemens, or square D breakers. The internal panel board is the preferred location for the breaker for Powerwall and wall connector. Under the internal panel board's lugs, this jumper is factory installed, connecting the internal panel board busing to the backup busing. The jumper should only be removed to isolate the internal panel board from the backup lugs, typically when local code requires a line voltage disconnect before power generation breakers. To install a breaker onto the internal panel board, engage the tab of the breaker onto the left side of the panel, then rotate the breaker contacts onto the busing. After all breakers are installed, secure them with the hold-down bracket included in the accessory kit. Begin by inserting the top of the bracket into this opening above the internal panel board. Fasten the bottom of the hold-down bracket using the T20 torque screw provided in the accessory bag. Run the branch circuit wiring from Gateway 3 to Powerwall. This will include line 1 and line 2 conductors, a neutral conductor, an equipment grounding conductor, and a 4-wire communication cable. Terminate the branch circuit wiring on the labeled terminals in Powerwall. Communication wiring is landed on these 4 terminals located on the taco. Terminate each of the 4 conductors on their respective ports as labeled here. Back in Gateway 3, terminate the branch circuit wiring for Powerwall on the breaker, neutral bar, and ground bar. The communication cable is terminated in here. Remove this connector to make the terminations. lift the orange tabs on the corresponding ports and insert the unstripped communication wiring into the connector. Use a small screwdriver to close each port that pierces through the insulation of the communication wires. Use of a screwdriver is important to create enough leverage to fully close the terminal. Lightly tug each conductor to ensure that it is properly seated in the connector, then plug the connector back into the islanding contactor. With wiring completed, the next step is to finish the installation by energizing, commissioning, and testing the system.